I am Dr. Eshar Pal, Assistant Professor, Contractual of Jamshedpur Women's College, Department of Zoology. सेमेस्टर फोर में बायोकेमिस्ट्री और मेटाबॉलिक प्रोसेस सिलेबस है, उसी का अंडर में कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म एक टॉपिक्स है। उस कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म के ऊपर आज हम ग्लाइकोलाइसिस पढ़ाएंगे। ग्लाइकोलाइसिस इज ए प्रोसेस। Glycolysis is a process, the process which means breakdown of sugar. Generally, after digestion, the food is absorbed in the form of glucose, and this glucose transport through blood reach into each and every cell and tissue, and inside tissue metabolic process goes on. Metabolic process, the process, the reaction, the chemical process which are going on inside the cell. So many metabolic processes are there, but carbohydrate metabolism is one in which glucose break down into small units, ultimate giving rise carbon dioxide, water, with the production of energy. And we know that energy is essential for all metabolic activities which are going on inside our body. Now student, the energy is actually obtained from food, and glucose is the main food, the main biomolecule which is the source of energy. Inside the cell, particularly in the cytoplasm, breakdown of glucose takes place. After breakdown, one mole of glucose produce 1 mole of glucose produce 2 mole of pyruvic acid. 2 mole of pyruvic acid. With the liberation of little amount of ATP. The breakdown is governed or controlled under the help of some enzymes which are present in the cytoplasm, and the process of glycolysis was studied by Emden, Miyarov and Parnas, due to which the whole process is also known as EMP pathway. EMP, Emden, Miyarov, Parnas pathway, or also known as glycolysis, that means breakdown of glucose. How the glucose breaks and how many steps are there towards the production of the 2 molecule of pyruvic acid, the steps I am going to represent in front of you. You see, student, glucose, you know, 6 carbon containing compound, which is also known as hexose sugar, we indicate by giving 6C, and first of all it converts into glucose 6-phosphate. Glucose 6P I have written here, that means glucose 6-phosphate. Glucose 6-phosphate again converts into fructose 6-phosphate. Fructose 6-phosphate converts into fructose 1,6-diphosphate. I mean 2 phosphorus will be added in the carbon position number 1 and carbon position number 6 of the molecules. That's why it is known as fructose 1,6-diphosphate. Fructose 1,6-diphosphate will now break into three phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, which we call as DHAP, dihydroxyacetone phosphate. These are now triose sugar. I am writing here 3C, 3C means 3 carbon containing compound, and this is also 3C. So these are all 6C compound. They are all 6C. All are hexose sugar. All are hexose compound. Now, fructose 1,6 diphosphate break and gives rise two molecules, each containing 3 carbon sugar, and these two are the 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Now, 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde and DHAP both are the same isomer, so one can convert into each one another, and with the help of the enzyme that is called triose isomerase. Triose in that sense because each compound contains 3 carbon, that's why it is called triose sugar, triose isomerase enzyme. Now the 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde converts into 1,3 diphosphoglyceraldehyde. 1,3 diphosphoglyceraldehyde. Glyceraldehyde, which again converts into 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde, which again converts into 3 phosphoglyceric acid. Glyceric acid. All are triose sugar. We can write here 3C, 3C, because that indicates each molecule contains 3 carbon. Now you see the 3 phosphoglyceric acid again converts into 2 phosphoglyceric acid. 2 phosphoglyceric acid later convert into 2 phosphoenol pyruvic acid. Enol pyruvic acid. And the 2 phosphoenol pyruvic acid later converts into 2 moles of pyruvic acid. One thing you see that here, fructose 1,6 diphosphate produced 2 triose sugar, and as this triose sugar, I mean dihydroxyacetone phosphate and 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde are both the isomer of each one another. So as it converts into this, so each and every steps we will indicate them, we can balance them by the multiplication of 2 moles each and every steps. 2 mole. 2 into matlab that indicates 2 moles of pyruvic acid. So you see that ultimately glucose convert into 2 molecule of pyruvic acid. It is hexose sugar, 6 carbon is there, and we are getting 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. That means we can write here 3C. Now question arises, how the conversion takes place? How means, which help, which can regularize the process? The process is actually regularized by the help of enzymes. We will now put the name of the enzymes. Glucose, you know that it is hexose sugar. And it is giving rise to glucose 6-phosphate. So one molecule of phosphate we are getting from ATP. That means here, ATP will convert into ADP plus plus inorganic phosphate. That means ATP convert into ADP by leaving one phosphate, which can add into glucose 6-phosphate. In the 6th position of glucose, one phosphate is adding here. And the enzyme is here, hexokinase. Now see, the glucose 6-phosphate and fructose 6-phosphate, both are isomer. So here we can give the name of the enzyme isomerase, but from the name of the compounds, that should be named as phosphoglucoisomerase. Then after, you see that fructose 6-phosphate getting fructose 1,6-diphosphate, when another phosphate molecule is adding here in carbon position number 1. So here another ATP will convert into ADP by giving one phosphate molecule to added in the carbon position number 1. That's why it has got the name fructose 1,6-diphosphate. Now question arises, the fructose 1,6 will break, will cleave, and which will be the enzyme? The name of the enzyme will be aldolase. You see here, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde getting, which will give 1,3-diphosphoglyceraldehyde, and here one conversion takes place, in which NAD reduced into NADH2, and NADH2 is equivalent to the 3 ATP, which will proceed towards ETP, electron transport system. So here each and every molecule is getting 2, 2, 2, 2. So ultimately NAD will be twice NADH2, NAD to NADH2, which will be equivalent to the 6 ATP, and this 6 ATP will move towards the electron transport system. Now 1,3-diphosphoglyceraldehyde converts into 2,3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, and here the enzyme will be glyceraldehyde dehydrogenase, 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde dehydrogenase. In that sense, NAD is reduced into NADH2, that's why the name of the enzyme will be dehydrogenase. Again, 1,3-diphosphoglyceraldehyde converts into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. It is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, enzyme name glyceraldehyde phosphoglyceraldehyde, and 3-phospho converted into 2-phospho, that is known as both are same 3-phospho and 2-phospho, they are adjusted in between the two. So here the name of the enzyme will be mutase. 2-phosphoglyceric acid converted into 2-phosphoenolpyruvic acid, that will be with the help of the enzyme enolase. And 2-phosphoenolpyruvic acid converted into pyruvic acid with the help of the enzyme pyruvate D kinase. That means whenever we are applying the ATP, using ATP, you see that there is also kinase. Here we are using, there will be phosphofructokinase. Now, we will see that here 1,3-phospho giving 3-phosphate. That means we are recovering ATP from ADP. ADP which combine with that phosphorus, inorganic phosphate, IP, and giving 2 ATP. We also write here 2 and 2, 2 ATP. We are getting. Similarly, you see that here, enol pyruvic acid, phosphoenol pyruvic acid, giving pyruvic acid. Here we also get 2 ATP. ADP plus IP giving 2 ATP. That means you see that initially we are using 2 molecules of ATP. Here we are using 1 ATP, here we are using 1 ATP. But ultimately, after breaking up this compound, we are recovering ATP. Where? Now, during the conversion of 1,3-diphosphoglyceraldehyde into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, there we are getting 2 ATP. And at the last, where we are getting pyruvic acid, there we are also getting 2 ATP. Ultimately, how many ATP we are getting here? 4 ATP. There is 2 and there is 2. That means we are getting 4 ATP. So, 4 ATP. And initially, we are using how many ATP? 2 ATP. Here and here. So, if we minus that 2 ATP, we have 2 ATP net again. Net again. And you see that here NAD reduced into NADH2, and I have told you 2 NADH2 is equivalent to 6 ATP, which proceeds toward running the electron transport system. Electron transport chain which will remain run inside the inner mitochondrial membrane. So there will be the need of energy. This 6 ATP will proceed towards ATS. So if we calculate the total energy in glycolysis, so that will be net gain 2 ATP, and towards ATS we are getting 6 ATP, that means total 8 ATP molecule we are getting from glycolysis. So any metabolic process, particularly glucose metabolic process, will proceed first of all the glycolysis. Glycolysis for the breakdown into glucose. Into which? Now into pyruvic acid. How many pyruvic acid? Now 2 mole of pyruvic acid. So 2 mole of pyruvic acid we are getting. And ultimately with that we are also getting 2 ATP as net gain. And we are also getting 6 ATP here. So total production of 8 ATP. So this is the breakdown of glucose into pyruvic acid. And this takes place where? In the cytoplasm. I have already told you that when food will be absorbed, glucose will be absorbed through blood stream. And it reaches into each and every cell and tissue. So inside the cell, the glucose enters. Glucose molecule is acceptable inside the cytoplasm because plasma membrane allows glucose molecule to enter inside it. So whenever glucose molecule enters into the cytoplasm, the metabolic process starts. That means glucose tends towards the breakdown of the pyruvic acid. Now question, why there is need of the breakdown of the glucose? Because I have told you, glucose is actually biofuels. It provides energy. So how we will get the energy? Energy is actually stored inside the glucose, but that molecules will break, and after breaking that will produce energy. So, glucose converting into pyruvic acid, that is not the ultimate product, ultimate result of the metabolic process. It is the one half of the process. Later on, this pyruvic acid proceeds towards the mitochondria to liberate maximum amount of energy, which you will study through Krebs cycle. This is glycolysis. And it was studied by Emden, Mayer of Parnas. That's why the process is also known as EMP pathway. Understand? So we have completed the total process of the glycolysis, how glucose converted into pyruvic acid, and how the enzymes are catalyzing the each and every steps, and how the production we are getting here. And you see that as this was the 6 carbon molecule compounds and we are getting 3 carbon containing compounds. So to make a balance, we have multiplied each and every step 2 into 2 into, that means in degree 2 mole. 2 mole, 2 mole, and ultimately we say 2 mole of pyruvic acid. Okay? So this is glycolysis. Understand? It is also another known as where? What? EMP pathway. And where it takes place? In the cytoplasm. Understand? Okay.